Greetings. Let me say right up front, I'm not setting a date. I only want to respect God and respect His Moedim. I really respect what Jesus said in Matthew 24:36. Matthew 24:36. No one will ever know anything about that day or hour, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, even after I return to my glory that I shared with Yahweh in eternity past, but only the Father. What? What do you mean that is not what it says? Oh, I see. I left something out. My bad. No one will ever know anything about that day or hour in advance. Not even the angels in heaven nor the Son, even after I am seated at the right hand of God, having returned to my glory that I shared with Yahweh in eternity past, but only the Father. That is exactly what every Christian I hear thinks it says. Jesus does not know and will never know in advance until God the Father taps Jesus on the shoulder.
Okay, son, time to get your shoes on.
Some of you may be getting offended because you do not get the point here. I am trying to respect what Jesus actually said and not what we have been taught he said. Matthew 24:36, as it's actually written. No one knows about that day or hour, not even the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. The word knows is present tense. I am being serious here. Knows is the present tense of knowledge. It means being in possession of the knowledge at the time the statement was made. This is just like the way Muslims misunderstand Deuteronomy 34:10. And there arose not a prophet since in Israel like unto Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. In the time between Moses and prophet Joshua completing Deuteronomy, there was no prophet in between. Islam completely brain farts this to think no prophet would ever again arise in Israel. The word knows is present tense. It means being in possession of the knowledge at the time the statement was made. Do you really think Jesus, who is God, is not now omniscient? Jesus is not now all-knowing. Do you recall that Jesus said he would answer your prayers? John 14:13, and I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Does your understanding of that verse assume God the Father, has to take all the messages for Jesus? God the Father is omniscient, while Jesus remains the second string. How close to God is Jesus in your thinking without actually being God? Do you find Jesus is Lord misleads your thoughts to Jesus is Master, and you slide right past Jesus is God? Jesus is Yahweh. John 10:30, I and the Father are one. John 14:9, Jesus replied, Philip, I have been with you all this time, and still you do not know me? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Zechariah 12:9, and in that day I will set about to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. Sounds like Yahweh God the Father talking, right? And I will pour out on the house of David and the inhabitants of Jerusalem a spirit of grace and pleas for mercy, so that when they look on me, on whom they have pierced, they shall mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, and weep bitterly over him as one weeps over a firstborn. That was Yahweh, God the Father, talking, right? Yahweh God, who the inhabitants of Jerusalem pierced. Yahweh God, who will set about to destroy the nations coming against Jerusalem. And in that day, I will set about to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. I was under the impression this is Yahweh, God the Father, talking, right? The church has a confused and watered down idea of who Yeshua is. John 16:12, I have many more things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When I hear Islam rape this text and claim Muhammad is the Holy Spirit, I get righteously angry. When I contemplate the church ignoring what the Holy Spirit has revealed, I get frustrated and sad. Malachi 3:1, Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. Yahweh God will come to his temple. Yahweh God will come as a prophet. Yahweh God will come as the prophet of the new covenant. Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. So I ask again, who is Jesus in your thinking? Do you really think that, fully restored to his glory, Jesus does not know something? No one knows about that day or hour, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. You might be thinking, was Jesus telling a lie then? Was Jesus telling a lie when Jesus said he did not know? Philippians 2:7. But emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. To humble is to make low, to lower one's position. When Jesus emptied himself of his divine glory, Jesus did not retain any of his divine attributes. Did Jesus retain any of his omnipotence? No. Did Jesus retain any of his omnipresence? No. Did Jesus retain any of his omniscience? No. Jesus, in his state of humility, of emptiness, did not retain his omniscience. That means being all-knowing. As such, when Jesus said, "No man knows, not even the Son," he spoke the literal and absolutely accurate truth of the situation when he spoke it. Given that, are you willing to entertain the notion, maybe, just maybe, now, the Son of God does know? If you still think Jesus does not and cannot know the day or hour, the rest of this video will probably just upset you. Still there? Well, I want to state clearly for the record, I am not setting a date. I am only trying to discern, to discover the date God set from the creation of the world. I look forward with eager expectation for the return of my Lord. We know there are seven feasts of the Lord, seven Moedim established by God, and we know that a spiritual fulfillment of the spring feasts happened. In fact, the first four feasts, the spring feasts, were fulfilled during the annual observance of those first four feasts. So a rational expectation from what we have seen from God is the fall feasts will likely be fulfilled during their annual observance. What then is the description of the next feast to be fulfilled? Leviticus 23:23. Again, the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Speak to the sons of Israel, saying, In the seventh month, on the first of the month, you shall have a rest, a reminder by blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation. You shall not do any laborious work, but you shall present an offering by fire to the Lord. Feasts were said to begin when the new moon was observed. That means observed by two priests in Jerusalem. Jerusalem, God's holy city. So when this year would the Feast of Trumpets begin? Not when is the civil holiday scheduled. When is God's Moedim scheduled based on how God schedules it? It can safely be said, no man knows the day the feast begins, because it only begins once two witnesses see the sliver of the new moon from Jerusalem. I can tell you the exact time when conjunction occurs. The new moon is at 5:30 Universal Coordinated Time, Wednesday, September 20th, 2017. That happens to be 8:30 a.m. in Jerusalem. At that instant, there is no sliver which can possibly be seen. What about only 10 hours later at sunset, 18:38 Jerusalem time? The chance of seeing something is still smaller than the sliver the moon appears to be. Maybe 24 hours later, sunset, 18:37 Jerusalem time. There is a reasonable chance, but not a certainty, it would be seen at that time. I can easily accept sunset, September 21st, the Feast of Trumpets would begin. But there is wiggle room. It might not have started until sunset, September 22nd. Remember, this is according to the way Yahweh God said He would schedule the feasts. That is, if He were God. So pick your time zone. Jerusalem, 18:37. Eastern Daylight, 11:37 a.m. Central Daylight, 10:37 a.m. Mountain Daylight, 9:37 a.m. Left Coast Daylight, 8:37 a.m. That is the instant in time the Feast of Trumpets begins. It ends 48 hours later, sunset, September 23rd. Jerusalem, 18:35. East Daylight, 11:35 a.m. Central Daylight, 10:35 a.m. Mountain Daylight, 9:35 a.m. Left Coast Daylight, 8:35 a.m. I trust the rest of the world can convert from UTC better than Americans, dumbed down by liberal education, can. And when does the last trump sound? Right as the feast ends. And if you are still here Monday, September 25th, one of several things happened. One, the rapture did not happen this year. Two, the rapture will simply never happen. That is a much riskier conclusion to leap to. 3. The rapture happened and you did not go. Don't go all foolish Virgin Airways on me. 4. The rapture happens later in the tribulation. Clearly it did not happen now, so the future would be later. Regardless, Do not panic, and do not give up your faith. The proceeding was an intellectual exercise and not setting a date. But if you fast and pray, it may be a good time, September 21st, to start a 3-day fast. So you be looking good in your bridal best. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.